Okay, we will continue. I think we have covered this fish body oils in earlier classes. So fish oils, basically we are having two kinds. One is the fish body oil, another one is the fish liver oil. Body oils are generally we are extracting from the fish body. Whereas the fish liver oils, we are extracting from the fish liver. Okay, so these fish livers are oils are having a therapeutic uses. Therapeutic uses in the sense in the pharmacy, they are using as a therapeutic for the treatment of vitamin A and vitamin D. But nowadays, this vitamin A, synthetic vitamins A is also available in the market at a cheaper price. So because of the low cost availability of this vitamins A, their importance has been decreased. But still, this liver oils is still having a rich source of vitamins A as well as vitamins D. Okay, so liver oils of halibut and tuna also are a rich source of vitamins A and D. And the most important sources of liver oils are the cod, haddock, shark, halibut, tuna. These are the species from where we can extract the liver oils. Okay. Then, so this is the example. This is, you can see here, this fish. This is the cod here. Cod fish. And this is the halibut fish. So from this fishes, we are extracting the liver oils. Okay. Then.
आवाज ठीक से नहीं आ रहा, कट कट के आ रहा
है. अभी आ रहा है. अभी आ रहा है क्या आवाज?
यस सर, अब थोड़ा सही हुआ.
हाँ, सो नाउ वी आर हैविंग ए क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ लीवर्स. क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ लीवर्स दैट मींस वी आर क्लासिफाइंग द लीवर्स. सो वेट ऑफ द लीवर एंड देयर फैट कंटेंट एंड वाइटामिन कंटेंट्स इट वेरीज फ्रॉम स्पीसीज टू स्पीसीज. इट वेरीज एंड इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द फिश स्पीसीज, their ages, nutritional status, and stages of spawning and biochemical composition of the feces. Weight of the liver, fat content, and vitamin contents, it varies. So in cod and haddock, liver accounts for 4 to 9% by weight of the whole fish, and the liver contains as high as 45 to 70% oil. Okay, so this is the cod and haddock. Then livers accounts for as much as 10 to 15-25% of body weight in some species of shark, which have a large fatty livers having a very high oil content in their range, 60 to 75%. That means high oil will be there in case of shark fish. In halibut, tuna and whale, the liver amounts is to 1% of the body weight and contains 4 to 25% of oils having high vitamins A and vitamin D potency. That means this group of the fishes is having a low oils and high vitamins potency. Okay. Sorry, percentage of high, having a high vitamins, okay, vitamins A and D potency. Then, based on the oils contents and the vitamin contents, fish livers is classified into three groups. First is the fish oils. They're having a high oils and low vitamins A potency. That means, jada oil hoga or kam vitamins A hoga. Then low oils and high vitamins A potency. Then third category is the high oil and high vitamin A potency. These are the three groups of fish liver. Then how we can extract the liver oils from the fishes? So for that, what we have to do, we must have to remove the liver from the fishes. And this liver is very perishable in nature. Why? Because of the high moisture contents and their bacterial load as well as the enzymatic activity. So we must have, if we are removing the liver from the fish, we must have to store, we must have to preserve it. So for that purposes, what we are doing, we are following some methods for the preservation of fish liver. So first we are, what we are doing, we are removing the liver from the fishes and we are storing and preserving in the crust ice. Like our in fish, we are doing the icing. So if we are doing the icing, we can store for 10 to 15 days for fish. But here liver, we can store in the crust ice in cold room for a couple of days, not more than that. If we are doing a freezing, that means we have to freeze the liver. We have to freeze the liver at minus, keeping into the minus 18 or minus 20 degrees C. So here we can store the liver for several months. Besides these two, chilling and freezing, other methods of preservation of fish liver is the, that is the temporary preservation. So what we are doing, first we are chopping the liver into very, very small pieces. And then we are mixing with 10% by weight of common salt. Chop kar lenge, chote chote piece mein, usme 10% by weight hum common salt dalenge. And then we are keeping into the airtight container. Second is the grinding the liver and preserving with 0.25% of its weight of formalin. Formalin, we can preserve into the formalin. We have to grind the liver and then we have to use 0.25% of formalin we have to prepare. And in that formalin, we have to keep our grind liver. Then grinding, third method, another method is the grinding the liver and keeping in aqueous solution of 2% of sodium carbonate containing some germicides. That means alkali solution we are preparing at the rate of 2%. In that alkali solution, what we are adding the germicide. Say for example, formaldehyde, phenol, resorcinol or alcohol. These are the germicides which prevent the bacterial multiplication, which prevent the growth of the bacteria or microbes. Okay, so these are the methods by which we can preserve the liver. Okay, after preservation, that means agar humne liver ko machhli se hataya aur turant process kar diya, it's okay. But processing time, it differs. Even though the which, what kind of processing methods will be applied to extract the oils from the liver, it depends upon the various condition. It depends upon the whether it is a high oil or low vitamins, whether it is a high oil or high vitamins, whether it is a low oils and high vitamins A potency. So if the methods will vary. Okay, so now we will go for the methods, how we can extract the oils from the liver. So extraction of oils from this liver, so these methods will vary depending upon the which kind of liver or which three categories of liver is there now. So based on that, the methods will vary. But extreme care is needed in processing liver with a low oil content of high vitamin potency. That means the liver which is having a low oil content but having a high vitamin A potency. So in such kind of liver, we have to do some care. We must have to apply some care. What is happening here, the oils and vitamins will be held closely, which will be connected to the proteinaceous tissue. So it is very difficult to open this proteinaceous tissue and remove the fat. So that's why we must have to take care if such kind of liver is there. Then first liver category is the liver having a high oil and low vitamin A potency. That means oils will be rich, but vitamin A potency will be less. So, what type of feces falls in this categories? So, especially liver of fish, feces like cod, haddock, and other species containing 50 to 70% of oil. 50 to 70% of oil is very high oil. But their vitamin A potency ranges from 500 to 20,000 USP units per gram of oils. So, very less vitamin A potency. Okay, the large volume of oils act as a solvent. As we know, this vitamins A and vitamins D, they are the fat soluble vitamins. So that's why the fat will act as a solvent to solubilize this fat, these vitamins. So here what we are doing, how we are extracting. So for that extraction of these oils, we are applying a method. What method? Processing method. We are applying direct or indirect steaming method to extract the oils from the liver. Okay, how we can go? So direct steaming method में क्या होता है? हम क्या करते हैं? इसमें हम we are introducing the steam directly. We are having a cooker. Cooker में हम liver को रखते हैं और उसमें हम steam को introduce करते हैं. So steam, if we are introducing the steam into the cooker, the temperature of the cooker will rise. Accordingly, the liver temperature will also rise. So temperature here we are maintaining 80 to 86 degrees Celsius. So because of the rise in the temperature at 80 to 86 degrees Celsius, the liver cells will be damaged. There will be thermal rupture of the liver cells. So if the liver cells are thermally ruptured, so it may release the oils into the cooker. Okay, so our focus will be, we have to heat continuously until and unless all the liver cells is going to disintegrate, all the liver cells is going to rupture completely. And the oils will release into the cooker and it may float on the top. So after that, what we have to do? We have to do the steaming process. Steaming process, जैसे हम चाय बनाते हैं, चाय बनाने में हम क्या करते हैं? चाय जब complete हो जाता है, तो we are doing this steaming. चाय को छानते हैं ना, तो like that also we have to steam the oils with liver. Okay? Then whatever the oils will come, we are keeping into the settling tank or centrifugation tank to remove the suspended solid and mush. So that is another refining process we are doing. Okay, so this is the direct steaming. That means here we are applying a direct steam into the liver soil, into the liver. So the thermally, the liver cells may be damaged or ruptured and oils may be released. And after that, we are steaming the oils and then keeping into the settling tanks and centrifugation tanks to remove the oils and moisture. So this is the direct steaming methods for a high oil and low vitamin A potency liver. Then another is the indirect steaming method. Here what we are doing, we are having a steam jacketed kettles like our this autoclave. So steam jacketed kettle is there. So here we are not directly applying the steam. So what we are doing here, we are heating indirectly by admitting the steam into the jacket, and the temperature here maintained as 70 to 75 degrees C. Okay, and in between, during the process, we are doing the steam process. जैसे चलाना होता है ना, जैसे खाना बनाते हैं तो भाई वो खाना बनते रहता है, खोलते रहता है, तो in between spatula लेकर के हम खाने को चलाते रहते हैं. So like that also here we have to steer the liver during the this process, this steaming process. So if we are applying the steaming process, it may facilitate the disintegration of the liver cells and it may release the oils from the liver. Then same we have to keep after release of the oils we have to steam steaming ke baad mein settling tank mein dalenge or centrifugation tank mein dalenge to remove the oils or moisture so this is the methods applied for a liver which is having a high oils and low vitamin C potency so this is the indirect steaming method now another category of liver is the liver having a low oils and high vitamin A potency so in such kind of liver what kind of processing methods we will apply to extract the oils so here especially the liver of halibut tuna lingcod and other species of sar that contains 4 to 28% of oils by weight and vitamin A potency having a range of 25,000 to 600,000 USP units per gram of oils so having a high vitamin A potency but low oil content so here what will happen as the oil is held more closely by proteinaceous liver tissue the simple steaming techniques will not release the oils without degrading vitamin A so here we are not allowing the simple steaming method or direct steaming methods so what we are doing therefore a process of digestion that means we are digesting the liver or solubilization that means we are solubilizing the liver okay so digestion or solubilization of protein is implied to release the enclosed oil and vitamin A what are the processes implied alkali digestion is there enzyme and alkali digestion is there acid digestion is there and solvent extraction is there so we will go one by one so in alkali digestion mein kya hai jo hamare paas liver hai us liver ko hum first kya karenge we are doing the grinding that means we are means chopping the fish liver making into this small pieces and then we are mixing with a 1 to 2% by weight of sodium hydroxide or 2 to 5% by weight of sodium bicarbonate these two compounds are strong alkali sodium hydroxide sodium bicarbonate denge to 2 to 5% agar sodium hydroxide dena hai to 1 to 2% theek hai then grounded fish meat fish liver with this alkali we are applying heat with live steam and maintaining the temperature of 82 to 87 degrees C and again this steaming process will be there during the cooking process or steaming process and the digestion liquor is then centrifuged to separate the oils so jab digestion khatam ho jayega tab hum usko kya karenge steam karke then we go to this centrifugation techniques but here we must have to take care kya take care karna hai we have to add this alkali hame utna hi alkali dena hai jitna wo us cheez ko digest kar de that means liver ko digest kar de hame excess alkali nahi dalna hai agar excess alkali dalenge to kya hoga there is a possibility that if any free fatty acid will be there okay so it may if the neutralization and other one is the saponification is there na process saponification process mein kya hota hai to prevent the saponification of oils saponification mein kya hota hai हेलो सपोनिफिकेशन में क्या होता है भाई हेलो
सर सोप का फॉर्मेशन होता है
सोप का फॉर्मेशन होता है लेकिन कैसे
सर ऑयल और अल्कोहल का रिएक्शन करवाते हैं
अल्कोहल नहीं यार अल्कली का रिएक्शन होता है
यस सर
अल्कली का रिएक्शन होता है
सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड
हाँ सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड है सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड अगर मतलब ऑयल्स है ऑयल्स के साथ में हम रिएक्ट करवाएंगे तो क्या होगा हमारा सॉल्ट्स ऑफ फैटी एसिड रिलीज बनेगा एंड दैट सॉल्ट्स ऑफ फैटी एसिड इज नथिंग इट इज ए So if we are providing a excess alkali, it may leads to the saponification. So we must have to add the quantity of alkali in such a way that only this alkali digestion may occur, not the saponification process, and also absorption of vitamin A in the soap fraction. So we must have to take care. Then another one is the enzyme and alkali digestion. इसमें क्या है, एंजाइम और अल्कली दोनों के साथ में हम डाइजेशन करते हैं. सेम प्रोसेस है, लीवर को हम क्या करेंगे, ग्राइंडिंग करेंगे, एंड ग्राइंडिंग करने के बाद में हम क्या करते हैं, वी आर मिक्सिंग विद इक्वल वॉल्यूम, दैट इज 1:1 रेशियो में लीवर और वाटर को मिक्सर बनाते हैं, स्लूरी बनाते हैं, और इस स्लूरी को हम क्या करते हैं, पीएच मेंटेन करते हैं 1.2 टू 1.5 बाय यूजिंग द कंसंट्रेटेड हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड. हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड वी आर यूजिंग 1. So pH here we will maintain 1.2 to 1.5. Then in that aqueous solution or slurry, we are adding a papain. Papain is an enzyme. So this enzyme, papain, we are adding 0.05%. And the mixture is maintained, and then we are heating 43 to 48% to increase the rate of reaction for a duration of 35 to 48 hours. Then in between kya hai, stirring karte rahenge, chalate rahenge to enhance the hydrolysis process. So at the end of hydrolysis kya hoga, pH of the mass jo hai usko humko badhana hai. Kyun? क्योंकि पहले जो हमने एंजाइम डाला था वो पेपेन था. पेपेन का जो ऑप्टिमम एक्टिविटी होगा वो हमारा पीएच रेंज 1.2 टू 1.5 के रेंज में उसका ऑप्टिमम एक्टिविटी होगा. सो फर्स्ट एंजाइमेटिकली वी आर डाइजेस्टिंग, बट आफ्टर दैट वी हैव टू डू अल्कली डाइजेशन. सो अल्कली डाइजेशन, इफ वी आर एडिंग द अल्कली, सो फॉर दैट वी हैव टू इंक्रीज द पीएच फ्रॉम 1.2 टू 1.5 टू पीएच 9. How? By using the saturated sodium carbonate solution, and it is further subjected to alkali digestion for another 1 hour at a temperature of 80°C. So what will happen? Once the alkali digestion is completed, so oil will be floated on the surface, which is recovered by centrifugation process. So this is the enzyme and alkali digestion. Now we are having an acid digestion. In acid digestion methods, what we are doing, we are doing grinding the liver and then adjusting its pH to 1.5 with an acid and cooking under constant stirring. So grinding करेंगे liver को, उसको क्या करेंगे, pH हम maintain करेंगे 1.5 by using this hydrochloric acid, and then cooking will continue with constant stirring process. Once the acid digestion is completed, oils will float, and that oils will be recovered by the centrifugation process. So that is the acid digestion. Then another method is the solvent extraction. Here we are using the solvent for the extraction of the oils from the liver. So here same thing, the liver we are doing the grinding process, and as much as water is possible is removed by steaming the ground mash. So hame jo liver hai उसको जब हम ग्राउंड करेंगे उसमें जो भी वाटर होगा, दैट वाटर वी मस्ट हैव टू रिमूव बाय स्टीमिंग द ग्राउंड माश. कैसे करेंगे, वी आर डूइंग द स्टीमिंग प्रोसेस ऑफ दिस ग्राउंड माश एट टेंपरेचर ऑफ 70 to 75 डिग्री सी फॉर ए लेंथ ऑफ 30 to 45 मिनट्स. दैट मीन्स आधा से पौन घंटे तक के लिए हम उसको स्टीमिंग करेंगे, कंटिन्यूसली स्टीरिंग प्रोसेस होते रहेगा. आफ्टर दैट उसको हम क्या करेंगे, ड्रेन करेंगे and the released water while the mass is still hot, aur pani ko hum hata denge. Then the residue is covered with a layer of paraffin or carbon dioxide gas and is rapidly cooled to around 20°C, and then after the oil is extracted with the solvent by using the one of the solvent. Koi ek solvent hame use karna hai, what are those? Acetone is there, ethyl ether is there, dioxin is there, benzene is there, alcohol is there. So several solvent is there. By using one of the solvent, we can extract the oils from this लीवर, ओके। उसके बाद जो सॉल्वेंट है उसको आपको सॉल्वेंट विद एक्सट्रैक्टेड ऑयल इज फिल्टर्ड एंड वैक्यूम डिस्टिल्ड टू रिकवर द ऑयल। सो दिस सॉल्वेंट प्रोसेस, सॉल्वेंट एक्सट्रैक्शन मेथड इज देयर। अनदर लीवर कैटेगरी इज द लीवर हैविंग हाई ऑयल एंड हाई विटामिन पोटेंसी। सो प्रोसेस विल बी सेम। सो लीवर कमिंग अंडर दिस क्लास आर टू ग्रुप। लीवर कंटेनिंग 30-75% ऑफ ऑयल, having a vitamin A potency in the range of 0 to 340,000 USP per unit per gram, and another liver is the containing 45-75% of oil with the vitamin A potency of 20,000 to 200,000 USP units per gram. So these two categories of livers is there. So because of this wide variation, the process employed will differ depending upon the characteristics of. So that means because based on this variation in the oils and vitamins, the process which we discussed, it may vary. So this is all about the liver oils, how we can extract liver oils. Basically, this liver oils having a use in the therapeutics to treatment, for the treatment of vitamin A and vitamin D deficient people. Okay, so this is about this fish liver oil. Which question hai to, then you may ask.
Hello,
bolo.
Ha, hello.
Ha, batao na.
हाँ सर, ये जो मेथड बताए थे ना आप स्टीमिंग का, दो मेथड था, डायरेक्ट और इनडायरेक्ट। हाँ। तो दोनों का क्यों जरूरत पड़ा? एक दोनों में तो स्टीमिंग प्रोसेस हो रहा है, तो डायरेक्ट और इनडायरेक्ट की जरूरत पड़ा सर?
कर सकते हैं, अगर हमारा जो क्वालिटी ऑफ ऑयल्स को मेंटेन करना है, डायरेक्ट वाला में हमारा ज्यादा डैमेज होने के चांसेस होते हैं, स्पेशली हमारा विटामिंस, ठीक है।
इसमें तो लास्ट में स्कीमिंग भी हो रहा है, तो सर तो दिक्कत भी आएगा ना सर? फिर तो सर
स्कीमिंग में दिक्कत नहीं है, जो है हमको अगर इफ वी आर अप्लाइंग ए हीट, इफ वी आर अप्लाइंग ए स्टीम डायरेक्टली टू दिस ऑयल्स, सो व्हाटएवर दिस दिस विटामिंस विल बी देयर व्हिच आर लेबल इन नेचर, इट मे डैमेज्ड। सो ज्यादा डैमेज हमारा डायरेक्ट वाले में होगा, इनडायरेक्ट वाले में कम होगा। हमारा फोकस रहता है, हमारा फोकस रहता है जितना से जितना हो हाई क्वालिटी ऑयल्स को भी मेंटेन करना है, निकालना है, और जितना से जितना हो सके मिनिमम डैमेज ऑफ विटामिंस को करना है।
ओके सर।
सो डायरेक्ट स्टीमिंग में हमारा चांसेस होता है ज्यादा, मतलब ये करने डैमेज होने का।
ओके सर, थैंक यू सर।
और कोई? और कोई? हेलो। एंड डायरेक्ट स्टीमिंग मेथड जो है और इनडायरेक्ट स्टीमिंग मेथड स्पेशली उस लीवर के लिए यूज करते हैं जो लीवर में ऑयल की क्वांटिटी ज्यादा होती है और विटामिंस की क्वांटिटी कम होती है, उसी के लिए हम वो मेथड अप्लाई करते हैं, ठीक है। क्योंकि डायरेक्ट स्टीमिंग हम करेंगे या इनडायरेक्ट में, डायरेक्ट में तो मैक्सिमम हमारा विटामिंस लॉस होने की चांसेस होते हैं, इनडायरेक्ट में समहॉट लेसर देन द डायरेक्ट स्टीमिंग मेथड।
ओके सर।
और कोई किसी को कुछ पूछना है तो पूछ लो। आई थिंक हमने बहुत सारा कवर किया है, फिश मील, ड्राई रिडक्शन, बिटर रिडक्शन, मेथड्स, स्पेसिफिकेशन, पैकेजिंग, स्टोरेज, फिश ऑयल, बॉडी ऑयल, लीवर ऑयल, एक्सट्रैक्शन, प्यूरिफिकेशन, प्रिजर्वेशन, स्टोरेज, एप्लीकेशन, बहुत सारे टॉपिक हमने कवर कर दिया है।
यस सर।
कुछ पूछना है
तो ये सारे के नोट्स कब तक मिल जाएंगे सर?
नोट्स दिया नहीं मैं।
नो सर।
अच्छा मैं ग्रुप में शेयर कर दूंगा पीपीटी, ठीक है।
ओके सर।
और मीन वाइल जो है यू कैन वॉच आवर यूट्यूब चैनल आल्सो।
यस सर।
दोज हु आर नॉट इन दिस क्लास ना यू कैन आल्सो टेल टू मींस वॉच दैट यूट्यूब चैनल सो दैट ही कैन आल्सो अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई टॉट हियर। ठीक है, कुछ क्वेश्चन है तो पूछो, अदरवाइज वी कैन क्लोज दिस सेशन। बोल ही नहीं रहा।
क्लोज सर।
क्लोज कर रहे हैं?
यस सर।
ठीक, कुछ पूछना है किसी को? नहीं ना।
नो सर।
चलो ठीक है फिर।
थैंक यू सर।